And now it's time for Jose's Theater. And now, here's the host of the show, Jose!
What, me? Oh, thank you. Thank you. Hello there, and Merry Christmas! Welcome to Jose's Theater. I'm your host, Jose. And today, we have some special guest stars. From Dr. Seuss the Grinch, we have the Grinch and Max. Say hi, Grinch. Say hi, Max. And today, we're going to read Dr. Seuss's Christmas story, How the Grinch Stole Christmas, by Dr. Seuss. So, ready to read the story? Here we go. Every who down in Whoville like Christmas a lot. See? Look. Here we go. But the Grinch, who lived just north of Whoville, did not. The Grinch hated Christmas the whole Christmas season. Now please don't ask why. No one quite with the reason of Christmas. It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right. Or it could be perhaps that his shoes were too tight. But I think that the most likely reason of all, it may have been that his heart was two sizes too small, right? No one quite knows the reason, right? Yeah, I forgot that part. Here we go. Well, I wonder what's next. Let's see. But whatever the reason that his heart of his shoes, he stood there on Christmas Eve, hating the Whos, staring down from his cave with a sore, grinchy frown at the warm, light windows below in their town. For he knew every Who down in Whoville beneath was busy now, hanging a mistletoe and wreath. They are hanging their stockings. He snarched with a sneer, right? Tomorrow is Christmas. It's practically here. Then he growled with his Grinch fingers nervously drumming. I must find a way. To stop Christmas from coming, for tomorrow he knew. Look, see. All the Who girls and boys would wake up bright and early, and they rushed for their toys. And then all the noise. That's one thing he hates. All the noise. Let's see. It's all that noise. Here we go. Then the Whos, young and old, would sit down to a feast. And they feast. They would feast on Who pudding and rare Who roast beast, which was something the Grinch couldn't stand in the least. Right? Feast. And then they do something he liked least of all. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, would stand close together with Christmas bells ringing, and they'd stand hand in hand, and the Whos would start singing. And they'll sing. And the more of the... All the singing. Yeah.
And the more the Grinch fought up his Who Christmas Sing, the more the Grinch fought, I must stop this whole thing. Why, for 50 years I've put up with it. Now, I must stop this Christmas from coming. But how? Finny got an idea, an awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea. I know just what to do. The Grinch laughed in his throat, and he made a quick Santa Claus hat and a coat, and he chuckled and clucked. What a great Grinchy trick. With this coat and this hat, I look just like Saint Nick. Look, see, what a Grinchy trick, right? All I need is a reindeer. The Grinch looked around, but since reindeer was scarce, there was none to be found. Did that stop the old Grinch? No, the Grinch simply said, if I can't find a reindeer, I will make one instead. So he called his dog Max. Right? Yeah. Then he took some red thread and he tied a great big horn on this top of his head. Look at that. See? He's a ring dog. Get it? A ring dog. Here we go.
Then he loaded some bags and some old empty sacks on a ramshackle sled.
Ramshackle sleigh. And he hatched up old Max. Then the Grinch said, gallop. Then the sleigh started down toward the homes where the Whos lay a snooze in their town. Then all their windows were dark, quiet snow filled in the air, though all the Whos were all dreaming sweet dreams without care. And when he came to the first little house on the square, this is stop number one. The old Grinchy Claus hissed, and he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist. Look at this. Look at that.
Here we go. Dum 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 dum. Then he slid down the chimney, a rather tight pitch. But if Santa could do it, then so could the Grinch. He got stuck only once for a moment or two. Then he stuck in his head out of the fireplace, flute. Were the little Whos stockings all the hung in a row? These stockings, he grinned, are the first things to go.
Yeah. And then he slithered and stunk with a smile most unpleasant around the whole room, and then he took every present, pop guns and bicycles, roller skates, drums, checkerboards, tricycles, popcorn and plums, and they stuffed them in the bags. And then the Grinch, very nippled, stuffled all the bags, one by one, up the chimney. Look at that, right?
That's not good.
Then he snuck to the icebox. He took the whole pudding. He took the roast beast. He cleaned out the ice pack as quick as a flash. Why, the Grinch even took their last can of Who hash.
hash rhymes with flash, right?
What was next? Then he stuffed all the food up the chimney with glee. And now, grinned the Grinch, I will stuff up the tree. And the Grinch grabbed the tree and he started the stove when he heard a small sound like a coo of a dove
or a pigeon like this. Coo, coo, coo.
Yeah, yeah. And he turned around fast and he saw a small who, little Cindy who was not more than two. The Grinch had been caught by this tiny who daughter who'd got out of bed for a cup of cold water. He stared at the Grinch and said, Santa Claus, why? Why are you taking your Christmas tree? Why?
See, that's not good.
Number six. But you know that the old Grinch was smart and so slick. He fought up a lie and he fought it up quick. Why, my little sweet little Todd, the fake Santa Claus lied. There was a light on his tree that wouldn't light on one slide and slid. And so I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there and then I'll bring it back here. Then his fib fooled the child. Then he patted her head and got her a drink of water and he sent her to bed. And when Cindy Lou Who went up to bed with her cup, he went to the chimney and stuffed the tree up. And then the last thing he took was the log for their fire. Then he went up the chimney himself, the old lair on their walls. He left nothing but hooks and some wires and the one speck of food he left in the house. And it was a crumb that even was small for a mouse.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. Then he did the same thing to the other who's house, leaving crumbs much too small for the other who's mouse.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Then it was quarter past dawn, all the who's still abed, and all the who's still snooze, when he packed up his sled, pack up with their presents and the ribbons and the wrappings, and the tags and the tinsel, the trimmings and the trappings. Three 3,000 feet up the sled of mint. Empty crumpet, he rode with his load to the tip top to the dump it. Pooh pooh to the who's. He was grinchishly humming. They're finding out that no Christmas is coming. They're just waking it up. I knew just what they'll do. Their mouths will hang up a minute or two. Then the who's down in Whoville will all cry boo-hoo.
Look, that's not good.
That's a noise, grinned the Grinch, that I simple must hear. So he paused, and the Grinch put his hand to his ear. Then he did hear a sound rising over the snow, and it started in a low, then it started to glow.
See? Look.
Okay. But the sound wasn't sad. Why, this sounded merry. It could have been so, but it was merry, very. He stared down at Whoville. The Grinch popped his eyes. Then he snook. What he saw was a shocking surprise.
What was next?
Every who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presents at all. He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came somehow or other, it came just the same. The Grinch, with his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages. It came without boxes. And it came out without bags.
Ooh.
And it came with 3 hours till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas, perhaps. He thought doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more.
Right? Here we go.
And what happened then? Well, in Whoville, they said that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day. And the minute his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whizzed with his load, fought the bright morning light, and he brought back the toys and the food for the feast. And he
look at that, look, see
himself. The Grinch carved the roast beast.
Beast, that is.
There it is. Look, see.
The roast beef.
Merry Christmas from the Grinch. The end. Do you like the story? I sure did. Do you like the story, Grinch? Yeah. And do you like the story, Max? Well, this music means that's all the time we have for today. Join us next time for another episode of Jose's Theater. Until then, keep reading and have yourself a Merry Christmas. I mean Christmas, that is. Say goodbye, Grinch, and say Merry Christmas. Say goodbye, Max.
And you drive a crooked horse, Mr.
Merry Christmas. I mean Christmas, that is. Bye-bye. Merry Christmas.
Sandwich with arsenic sauce.